God of covenant, faithful promises. Time and time again, you have proven you'll do just what you say. Though the storms may come and the winds may blow, I'll remain steady.
Over, we are deep into 2021 and we are thankful to God for the opportunity to gather again, break fresh bread, enjoy it for our nourishment and drawing us closer to God, the God who comes back, the God who is not afraid to ensure that what is said will come to pass, the God who walked with Father Abraham, the God who comes to ensure. This is the story of Abraham. And in 2021, we want to assure ourselves that you're serving a God who fulfills. We're serving a God who comes back to ensure it happens. So we are reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 18. We'll read verse 10. Genesis 18, verse 10. Then he said, I will certainly return to you about this time next year. And behold, Sarah, your wife, will have a son. And Sarah had it in the tent door that was behind him. The God who comes to fulfill. Shall we pray? Gracious Father in heaven, we are thankful for the opportunity of gathering together in our separateness, that you would speak to us this glorious day. So we commend ourselves to you, that indeed you'll be glorified in all we do. This is indeed our prayer of faith, in Jesus' name. Amen. We read the story of Abraham. Abraham and his wife, they had stayed for long without a child. And God, who makes changes, appears to him. And at the oaks of Mamre, where Abraham was seated and was living, happy and content with his wife, loving each other, and he saw three men come to him. He was quick to invite them and offer them something to eat. It's indeed nice to know that it is important to be kind and generous. Who knows who you may be entertaining? This is the God who came to visit with servant Abraham, God who came to speak to him and encourage him. Three men, the theophany, three men appearing, and they spoke to him and they talked. And at the end of it all, God said to him, I will surely return. That is the promise of God, that he will surely return. He will surely come back. He will surely turn your life around. He will surely fulfill what he has promised. He will surely appear, for he is not ashamed. For he who has begun the good work will see it to completion. He will surely return. This 2021, I want to tell you, God will surely return. You can take that to the bank. You can depend on him. You can lean on him. You can count on him. He'll surely come back to fulfill that which he has promised. Secondly, the time limit is set. I will be back this time next year. So the time limit that God has set to come and visit with you, the time limit that God has set to come and fulfill his promise, has been set. Depend on him. A time that is set will surely come to pass. So lean on him. Count on him. This 2021, walk with him. Time limit. You may be going through a tough time, but the limit has been set. It may appear like the waves will come to you, but the limit has been set. They will not cross a certain time. It may appear like you're going through a dry spell, but the limit has been set. Indeed, it is important to note that the time set will surely be fulfilled. So God says He will return. He'll surely return at this time next year. Why? Because Sarah will have a son. She had stayed for long. She was past childbearing age. They had depended on that, but now she will have a baby. It may look like everything has gone wrong. It may look like everything has been lit. It may appear like everything has been written off. But the God of the promise has said there will be a son by Sarah at this time next year. So the time has been set, the blessing has been pronounced, and that which has been said will surely come to pass. That is why God is coming back to ensure that what He has said has been fulfilled. He is coming back to encourage you so that you know His assurance is there. It may look tough and bleak. It may look unpredictable in 2021. Many things have been said, negative things. Some may be positive. Some may be out of this world. But it's good to know that the God of the promise will surely come back. That the God of the promise will surely fulfill it. That the God of the promise does not depend on environment or age or the biological clock or the chronometer or the height or the depth of your education or the roots that you have. He has promised to bless you. His blessing is specific. It is not a guess. It is not a maybe. It is not we will find out then. He has promised now. He is going to come. He is that confident that what He has said will surely come to pass. And Sarah also had the story. Of course, the verses that follow after that is how she laughed, how she doubted, how God rebuked her, and how He finally still came. And Isaac, the child of laughter, was born after being waited for a quarter of a century. Indeed, Sarah asked herself many questions, but whatever the questions that you may have, God has an answer to them all. God has an answer to your question on finance, to your question on the family, to your question on your health, to your question on your future. He has an answer. Depend on Him and listen to Him this 2021. Don't drift. So as we press on, remember, He's the God of the promise, and He returns, for He is sure it is going to happen. Depend on Him, won't you? Father in heaven, we are thankful for being together with us, for speaking to us this morning, reminding us that you are faithful and that which you have promised you shall surely fulfill. So come and fulfill your promises to us. Come and brighten up 2021 for us. Come and shine your light on us. For the sake of Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. And now may the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you, remain upon you, and dwell amongst you, both now and forevermore. Amen. Be blessed. You surely return. You surely return.